Look at this example that shows a force in 3D. The force F makes an angle theta sub x with x-axis, theta sub y with y-axis, and theta sub z with z-axis. If you know these three angles, you can easily find the components of this force on each axis. For example, the x component of this force is the magnitude of this force times the cosine theta sub x. You can do this for each axis. The y component of this force is the magnitude of this force times the cosine theta sub y, and so on. The angles theta sub x, theta sub y, and theta sub z define the direction of the force, so the cosines of these angles are known as direction cosines. Solving problems using direction cosine is a nice, elegant approach. Unfortunately, these angles are not commonly available in real problems. Look at the flower pot problem that we discussed earlier. How do we find these cosine angles? We can assume, for simplicity, that the three forces carry equal load and make the same angle with the vertical y-axis. But we still don't know how the other angles, angle with x-axis and z-axis for each force. The only way to find these angles is for someone to physically measure or calculate. So for even a simple problem like this one, the angles between a force and each of the axes is not readily available. In such cases, we may want to explore other approaches.